Hey everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun, back with a bunch of cute little bugs. A few weeks ago, I created this card. It was inspired by some lovely penguins wandering around the Shedd Aquarium in Chicago. And after I finished that card, I knew that I wanted to use the Build an Aquarium die set again to create vivariums. And you saw it on the thumbnail, the mice family is back, but they're not the stars of the show here. This card is all about cute bugs. So I started by stamping all my images on white cardstock using jet black ink. I used the coordinating dies to cut them all and colored everything using my alcohol markers. When the coloring was done, I die-cut a slimline panel out of vanilla cardstock. I masked a thin strip at the bottom using washi tape. That strip will be the floor. And I taped the brick stencil on top of the paper to create a nice wall all over the panel. I used walnut stain distress ink and I started by covering the entire panel using my blending tool. And next, I came back on a few spots to add more ink and this way create an uneven and more realistic wall. Next, I smooshed my walnut stain ink pad on my glass surface. I mixed it with water and used a thin brush to create lots of splatters on my panel. Once the ink was dry, I moved the washi tape and created a very simple floor using anti-linen distress ink. I removed the washi tape very carefully, not to rip the paper up, and next I moved on to the vivariums. I started by cutting the frames out of chocolate bar cardstock and the tops and bottoms out of paperback cardstock. And because I wanted all the elements to match, I added a little bit of walnut stain distress ink on the top and bottom pieces. Next, I created the backgrounds of my vivariums. I first traced the shape of the aquarium die on white cardstock, 3 times, and I used distress inks to color those 3 elements. I first applied evergreen bar all over the paper, and next I used Lucky Clover to add more depth on the 4 edges. Of course, I added texture to those 3 pieces. Water drops first that I dried using a paper towel, and then drops of Lucky Clover distress ink mixed with water. Here are all the elements. I white heat embossed my sentiment on 2 strips, and I also cut the frame 3 times out of a thick cardstock to create dimension. I applied double-sided tape at the back of those frames and assembled the vivariums. I started by attaching a thick frame on a green background. Next, I applied liquid glue at the back of a chocolate bar frame and stuck it on top of the thick frame. On the left and right sides, I also glued a thin strip. And finally, I attached the top and bottom strips using liquid glue again. I let the glue dry, I trimmed off the green panel that was peeking out, I assembled the 2 other vivariums, and finally I stuck those 3 elements on my brick slimline panel. Once again I trimmed everything that was peeking out of the panel, and to ground those little scenes I cut 3 hill borders. I colored them using gathered twigs and ground espresso distress inks, and attach them at the bottom of each vivarium. Before attaching the images, I thought it would be fun to add signs to know what to expect after or before those vivariums. So I used the Herald's ABC stem set along with the arrow from OpenMe to create those signs. So I stuck those pieces using liquid glue, and next I filled up the 3 vivariums with the images. I mostly use glue dots to stick everything, and also a little bit of liquid glue and a few foam squares at some places. Thank you. Once everything was attached, I added white highlights on the images to make them pop, and I stuck my panel on a ground coffee card base. I cut the excess of paper on the right side and used the bone folder to fold the card base nicely. And that's it. This is the final result. So tell me, which one is your favorite? And where do you want to go next? The mantis or the spiders? If you look for me, I will be at the snack bar. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time. Bye!